of behavior, newness of lifestyle, newness within and without, with affirmed crucifixion. Galatians chapter 2, reading from verse 20. Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I. The old me is not alive anymore. The old me that will get angry at, you know, the snapping of the finger. The old me that is covetous. The old me that is traditional. The old me that's, you know, everywhere watching over people, not watching over myself. The old me going in, arresting them and committing them into prison. Not I anymore. Neither do I live anymore, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me, the sanctification. And I pray that the Lord himself will do this deep work of sanctification in every life in Jesus' name. The Son has taken away your voice over there. Yeah. Amen. He will do it. We'll come to point number three now. Point number three is our service, Lord, compelling service with prevailing faith. The kind of service that is compelled by love. The service that God accepts, the service that God will reward, is the service that is propelled and compelled by love. When you are compelled by the love of God and you say, Lord, here am I, for what you've done for me, I'm saved, I'm sanctified. All I can do is to respond and pay in a little way because your love compels me. That is service. As we talk about service, what service is? Seeking the lost for Christ. Seeking the lost for Christ. If you are not seeking the lost, if you are just in one place there, and you think you are serving God, you're not even interested about people who are getting saved. You're not interested in counseling those who are getting saved. You're not interested in seeking out and going out to the people who are not saved to be saved. Jesus said in Luke chapter 19, verse 10, for the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. That's the service. Look at verse 13. In verse 13, he called his 10 servants and delivered them 10 pounds and said unto them, occupy till I come. If I were here every day, every moment, every time, at every opportunity, I'd be seeking to save that which was lost. And you are there standing in for me, representing me, occupy until I come. When we say there is service, it means we exalt loyalty above convenience. At times the service will not be convenient, but there is one word in us. It is the word loyalty, and we exalt that loyalty. He called me, and he expects me to be faithful. He called me, he expects me to be loyal. And we exalt loyalty above our convenience. In Acts chapter 20, verse 24, it says, but none of these things move me. None of these things move me. Persecution, pain, problem, whatever, and wherever it's coming from, none of these things move me. Neither count I my life dear unto myself, so that I might finish my course with joy. And the ministry which I have received of the Lord Jesus to testify, to preach, to proclaim the good news, the gospel of the grace of God. And we push all your discomfort behind, seeking for convenience, push all that behind. You exalt loyalty above convenience. And then are retaining the landmarks without compromise. You'll not say, well, salvation. We're not talking about repentance. I want the people to be saved. We're not talking about repentance. How will they be saved without repentance? We look for healing, explosive miracle, and people, blind eyes opening, the deaf hearing, and the lame rising up and walking. We're not going to talk about sin. We're not going to talk about new life in Christ. We cannot talk about righteousness now. This is the moment, and this is the day of miracle. You remove the ancient landmarks because you're in pursuit of miracle. Talk about everything. The word for the whole world from the Christ who has sent us. In Proverbs chapter 22, verse 28, remove not the ancient landmarks which thy fathers have set. Remove not the ancient landmarks which thy fathers have set. Martin Luther evangelized, but still emphasized. John Wesley saw great miracles. He still emphasized holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Charles Finney evangelized and still emphasized the life a born again believer ought to live. That's what we do. We don't say this is a miracle time and this is a, you know, explosive time, and therefore forget the old ancient landmarks. In serving the Lord, we retain the landmarks without compromise. It tells us in 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 15. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 15. Meditate upon these things and give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to all. And then in verse 16 says, take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine. Continue in them. You are evangelizing, continue in them. And you are praying for people to have explosion of miracles. Continue in them. For in doing this, thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee. V is visualizing the Lord at his coming. What will he find in your hand? How will he meet you when he comes? As you're serving the Lord, you're asking, will this be acceptable to him at his coming? Visualizing the Lord at his coming. In Luke chapter 12, verse 40, be therefore ready also, for the Son of Man cometh at an hour when ye think not. In verse 41, then Peter said unto him, Lord, speakest thou this parable unto us, or even to all? Verse 42, and the Lord said, who then is that faithful and wise steward, whom his Lord shall make ruler over his household, to give them their portion of meat in due season? I, increasing our labors through cooperation, increasing our labors through cooperation. There are evangelists, there are counselors, there are singers, there are technical people, there are ushers. You all cooperate together, work together in one accord, so that your labor and the fruit of your labor will increase. In 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 6, I have planted, Apollos watered, cooperation, but God gave the increase. See, calling the lawless out of eternal condemnation. Calling the lawless, those who act as if there were no law, no principle, no commandment from the Lord. There are men who act like that. I'm in the church. I just choose this as my church. As for all you're expecting to conform to the word of God, to live by the word of God, I didn't come here for that. They're lawless. Women who say they are part of the church, I hear that. I hear the emphasis on holiness, but I'm not here for that. I came just because, you know, my friend is here and I like to be here. You're not here. Your heart, your mind, your personality is not here. You're like, is that Jacob? I hear the voice of Jacob, but I feel the skin of Esau. Be a person that if you are there, you are there. You accept the word of God. To be in Deeper Life Bible Church, you have to accept the Bible, believe the Bible, embrace the Bible. We're not looking for numbers of a mixed multitude. The people you say are there. Aren't you happy, Pastor? I'm a member of your church now. I said I'm not happy yet until I see that evidence of salvation, that you are born again, that the power of the cross has effect upon your life. That is what the Lord expects. And I pray you'll be a real member of the church of the living God in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. And so the Lord wants us to get all those lawless people out of condemnation and bring them into the Lord. He is engaging in limitless liaisons for the great commission. I see, brother dear, he's really born again. I didn't know him before. I said, come on, take my hand. We have a lot to do together. I see another person there, his sister there, and then I say, you are born again. What are you doing? There's a lot of work to do. Let there be limitless liaisons, joining hands together, and joining hands together, people of the same mind and people of the same concept, and they say, we're going to win our world for Christ. As you do that, all the grace, all the power, all the strength, all the might, all the anointing, all the unction, all the energy, divine energy you need, the Lord will grant unto you in Jesus' name. In 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 19, for though I be free from all men, yet I made myself servant unto all, that I might gain the more. I bend low, I humble myself, I make myself a servant unto all, that you and I, that we and them, that all of us may bring more souls into the kingdom. And then in verse 22, it tells us in verse 22, it says, to the weak became I as weak, and I don't push them away. I don't say, no, we don't need you. We all come that I might gain the weak. I am made all things to all men that I might by all means, by all methods, by all strategies, in all ways, by all means, save some. In verse 23, it tells us, and this I do. Not only that I did it in the past today, this I do. Joining hands with them, forming limitless liaisons because of the great commission, inviting them to come, accepting them to come. If they're children of God and they're born again, because sinners cannot win sinners to the Lord, if they're children of God, this I do. For the gospel says that I might partake thereof with you, that you might be partaker thereof with me. We'll do it together. I said we'll do it together. Number one is the life-converting salvation that we have by personal faith. Number two is the love-confirming sanctification by purifying faith. And number three is the Lord-compelling service with prevailing faith. And I pray this kind of faith that works in us, works on us, and works through us, and touches other lives, personal faith, purifying faith, prevailing faith, will be in every one of our lives in Jesus' name. God bless you. God lift you up. God put all his great, all his might into you. And God transfer the zeal he has given me, the love he has given me, the passion he has given me, that all these many years has not died down. He will give you that kind of love, that kind of passion, that kind of unction, that in this your life, you will demonstrate sanctification, salvation, sanctification, and service unto the Lord. I invite you, don't be different. Be like me as I am in Christ. And the grace of God will keep on multiplying in every one of your lives. Where are you? Why don't you stand up and say, Lord, here am I. I'm ready. I've heard, I accept, I believe, I would live like that. Open your mouth and pray.
I can pray. Let everybody pray. Let's all rise up and pray. Let's talk to the Lord. The Lord has called us into his service. He has invited us to serve him. Salvation, sanctification, service. Pray unto the Lord. If you are not yet saved, wherever you are now, pray and say, Lord, here am I. I offer myself to you. Here am I. The Savior is here with his saving power to save every willing soul. All who are here physically, all who are connected with us online, wherever you are now, please close your eyes and pray. Close your eyes and pray. The service is not over. Nobody should go yet. Don't go yet. It's time to pray. The Lord has ministered unto us. The Lord has spoken to us. We need to pray. We need to talk to the Lord. Pray. The Lord has ministered unto us salvation. Get it now. The Savior is here. Receive. Sanctification. The Sanctifier is here. You have heard his word, the sanctifying word. The sanctifying fire power is available now. Receive. If you have been saved, you are not yet sanctified. Get sanctified now. So you have the genuine love, the burning zeal for the kingdom of God, for the service of God. Pray. Let everybody pray. Call upon the Lord. Oh Lord, let your sanctifying fire, let your sanctifying power touch me. Touch me. Sanctify me. Purify my heart. And then dedicate yourself unto the Lord. Lord, I will serve you. From today, all through the days of my life, I will serve you. I will serve you. I rededicate myself to you. I surrender myself to you. I will live for you. I will serve you all the days of my life. Pray. 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 The Lord is hearing. The Lord is hearing. And whatsoever blessing you desire from heaven, the great God of heaven is ready to do it for you. Lift up your voice and pray. The man of God has declared the counsel of God. And whatsoever you desire, salvation, sanctification, anointing and power for service, strength, wisdom, to serve God fruitfully, profitably, pray. If you need healing and health, you want to serve God, and there is challenge about your health, pray. The Lord will give you health, will give you strength, will give you healing to serve him. Everything you need to serve God and serve him profitably and serve him fruitfully, he will give to you. Pray, pray, pray unto the Lord. It's prayer time. Now is prayer time, and you don't leave until you have really fully prayed and we have rounded up together. We need to round up together in God's presence with prayer. Don't go yet. Make sure you are praying. Make sure you are talking to God. The Lord has spoken to us. He's listening to your voice now. He wants to hear your commitment. He wants to hear your commitment. He wants to hear your dedication. Pray unto the Lord. Pray unto the Lord. Salvation, sanctification, dedication for service. Now, pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let me hear your amen. In Jesus' name we pray. Now you want to give your life to Christ, you want to begin to follow the Lord Jesus Christ. We want to be saved by the Savior. Raise up your hand. We want to pray for you now. Raise it up wherever you are. Raise it up well. God bless you. All eyes closed. You want to be saved? You want to be set free from sin? Or you were saved before, you went back, you want to come back now to the Savior? Raise up your hand. Raise it up well. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, O Lord, for all who are indicating their desire to be saved from sin, from Satan. Lord, we plead you have mercy on them. Save them all in Jesus' name. Set them free from sin. Give them the power, the strength to live the godly, righteous, holy, sanctified life from today in Jesus' name. We pray that they will live for you. You will deliver them from the bondage and shackles of sin. And every day, every time, everywhere, they will live for you in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for the answer. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And amen. Our counselors, our ushers are around you there. Please collect a slip from them. We want to be of more spiritual benefits to you. And fill in the slip so we can be in touch with you and be of more spiritual blessing to you. Now, all of us together, you want to be sanctified and you are dedicating yourself to the service. Where are you? Where are you? Sanctification, dedication to the Lord's service. From today to the end of my life, I will serve the Lord. Where are you? You want to serve the Lord. You will serve the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, we are praying, O Lord, that you sanctify all who need to be sanctified here. And for all who are already sanctified and are rededicating themselves to you, we pray you help everyone to live for you every day, every time, everywhere, in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray together we will serve you. Together. We will follow you. Together, we will walk with you and be fit for eternal rest in heaven in Jesus' name. We give you glory. We give you praise. Thank you, Lord, for answering our prayers. Lord, we pray you renew the strength of your servant through whom you have ministered to us and use him much more for us in Jesus' name. And all of us together, we make it to heaven together in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for the answer. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. A louder amen. stars. Amen. God bless you. Let's be seated for a while. God bless you. God bless you. Let's be seated for a while. Once again, we very much appreciate the cooperation of every one of us, how we have been together in this program since Thursday, and we thank God for how the Lord has used our Father in the Lord, the convener of this program, Pastor W. F. Kumuyi, whom the Lord has used to minister unto us. He is praying for every one of us. He actually planned to be with us, and but he couldn't, and he's praying for us. He loves us. He appreciates us. He appreciates our commitment and dedication and service. And as the Lord has used him to minister unto us in this last session, remember, salvation, sanctification, and service. His prayer and desire for every one of us is that we will serve the Lord together and make it to heaven together in Jesus' name. Amen. God's word, doing God's will, and getting to heaven together. That's his prayer for us. That's his desire for us. All of us, we make it together in Jesus' name. Stars, standing tall as rising star. Go and shine every day, everywhere, and the Lord bless you bountifully in Jesus' name. Thank you. God bless you.
As I go back from here, Father, I want to continue to be in your hand. Brethren, pray, tell God to hold your hand. The road is so slippery and narrow. The road is so busy. Tell God to hold your hand. As you pray sincerely, God is ready to hold your hand. God is ready to hold your hand. Sister, brother, my children, worker, pray that God will hold your hand. That this race, God will keep you to the end. Open your mouth and begin to pray and worship and say, God, I need you. Holding my hands on daily basis. Children, if God hold your hand, the enemy cannot attack you. When you are going on the way and they see God holding you, nobody can attack you. If you are even sleeping in the night and God is holding your hand, nobody can attack you. Open your hands, say God. Open your mouth and say God. Hold my hands, Jehovah God. He will do it for you as he sincerely prays. He's searching your heart. He knows what you are praying for, and he's going to hold your hand. What are those challenges you have been passing through? If God hold your hand, victory is sure for you. Hold your hands. Hold my hand. Hold my hand, Jehovah God. I cannot cross alone. I cannot cross alone. The road is slippery and narrow. I will not be able to go on myself. Oh God, I need your help. Open your mouth and pray for God, assistant. He will do it for you as you pray sincerely today. Pray, pray that every word you are going to hear today, it will make your hand to be fixed in the hands of the Lord. Pray, children, teacher, pray, commit yourself into the hands of God. As you pray this morning, I tell you, you will never remain the same. The finger of God will be felt in your hand. People around, as you go back home, they will be seeing it, literally seeing that God is really holding your hand. You will not fall, you will not stumble. Yes, I believe that for you. Open your mouth and pray. Let's pray for our said decision leader as he stands to give us the word. The letter that killeth will not proceed out of his mouth, but will beat upon his word. The word will come in a new dimension. It will come in a new dimension, and it will transform your life. Thank you.
So great is thy faithfulness, O Lord my Father. There is no shadows of thine within.
Thou changest not, and thy compassion never failed on. To trust in Jesus, just to take Him at His word. Oh, so rest upon His promise, just to know. So Jesus.
to give up. But then you remember that there's more to live for. Emotions, hate, injustice, the world betrays. But I'm here today to remind you that Jesus is the only way.
And sometimes I wonder what good I am to the world. But the Creator, He comes to remind me from His word that I am a reflection of His glorious being and the bright image. And no darkness in this world can dare erase or defame.
Hence, his constant reassurance inside of me. I may not understand life's flow, but I know one thing for sure, that Jesus got me. So I remind myself daily that Satan, get thee behind me. For Jesus has won the battle for me.
Give you rest. You want to be a rising star above the clouds? Then take his say it from the Lord. Hallelujah. His message unto you I'll give. For it is recorded in his word. Hallelujah. It's only that you look and leave. Look and leave, my dear friend. Leave. Look to Jesus now and leave. For it is recorded in his word. Hallelujah. It's only that to you and me. Holy, 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 holy. Jesus, you are holy, 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 holy is the Lord, holy is the Lord, see, holy, holy. Convocation, I pray the Lord will visit you. If you believe that, I want to hear the loudest hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Alpha, Omega, Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of my praises today. You are worthy of my praises today. Alpha,
Alpha, Omega. Alpha, Omega.
You are worthy of my praises today. You are worthy of my praises today. Your hands unto Jesus. Wherever you are, can you bring your feet up? us to praise the name of Jesus together.
Alpha, Omega, Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of my praises today. You are worthy of my praises today. Alpha,
Alpha, Omega, Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of my praises today. You are worthy of my praises today.
Alpha and Omega,
Alpha, Omega, Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of my praises.
Praises today, Alpha,
Alpha, Omega, Alpha, Omega.
Hey,
you are worthy of my praises today. You are worthy of my praises today.
You are worthy, O Lord. You are worthy, O Lord. You. Hola.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Earning your degree online is closer than you think. Apply today to Purdue University Global.
It's wonderful to be here. Shout stars! We now want to take our congregational song. We are singing stand up for Jesus. Ye soldiers of the cross, lift high his royal banner. It must not suffer loss. From victory unto his army shall he lead, till every foe is vanquished, and Christ is Lord indeed. Stand up for Jesus. The trumpet call obey. Fought to the mighty conflict. In this is glorious day. Yea, that our men now serve him against innumerable foes. Let courage rise with danger and strength to strength oppose. Stand up for Jesus. Stand in his strength alone. The arm of flesh will fail you. You dare not trust your own. Put on the gospel armor and watching unto prayer. Where duty calls or danger, be never wanting there. Stand up for Jesus. The strife will not be long. The day, the noise of battle. The next, the victory's song. To him that overcometh, a crown of life shall be. He with the King of glory shall reign eternally.
Thank you.
We shall continue our variety activities in all the two sections, the children's section and the youth section. Let's continue our variety now.
Standing tall as a rising star. Standing tall as a rising star. Stars. It is time now for our variety. And we have a couple of varieties to challenge us this evening. So without wasting much time, we're going to call on the first set of candidates for the variety. Abigail Iyanabo and Robson Akife for spoken words. Let's put our hands together for them as they come up. Please put your hands together. Until they get here, don't stop clapping. Clap, 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 clap. Clap, clap, clap. Put your hands together. Clap.
Walden University is all about change. It's time.
Oh, Abigail, I'm giving up. I think I've had enough. Was I doomed and destined to be a failure?
No, champ. You can't give up.
No, I don't think so.
You are a star.
I said I don't think so.
Oh, yes, you are a star.
Oh, you don't get it.
Guess what?
This star is behind bars.
Oh, what bars?
Bars of sin and addiction. I'm trying to break free, but it seems I'm locked in. I can't see clearly. My vision is blurry. Oh, I'm lost. Lost in a world full of sinful dust, dust of addiction, masturbation, fornication, and pornography.
Oh, yes, you can still be a star.
Oh, I doubt.
But why?
My life is marred, dark with my addictions. Oh, I'm heading slowly to destruction and perdition. I'm crying out, who will help me out, for I am weak.
You are strong. Now listen. Have you heard about man, our mighty king, who is loving and caring? When I could not cope with life, cause all my hope for life was lost. My life was rusting and lost. A wretch I was, drowning in sin. I was a bound down cause my life was abominable. Satan kept dragging me from the maker. I was feeble cause I had mingled with sin. And then I cried out, who would let me out of these chains? My heart is in pains. I'm in the chains of the devil to be slain. Or am I living in vain? No, the answer came from a bright light, saying, dear child, I was bruised for iniquity. Do not allow the devil quit your life. My blood is a flood that will flush your sins away. All you need do is follow the way that leads to the cross and plead for mercy, and you'll be free. So I crawled to the cross and cried for mercy. And Jesus, he came through for me. He took away the pains of sin and made me a saint. He took away my unrighteousness and made me righteous. He took away my sinfulness and made me sinless. He took away my identity of a non-entity. He took me from the ground and gave me a crown. And now I'm free to dream and make the dream real. You are a star.
I am a star.
Oh, yes.
I am a star.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I am a star.
And you are a star.
Jesus has given you the might to fight and ignite your life, because your future is bright. Arise, star, and shine brighter.
Thank you.
God bless you.
You are a star. Say, I am a star. Keep on shining where you are. Amen. This second variety will thrill you. This is a special mouth organ to be presented by Jeremiah Abba. Jeremiah Abba, please come to the stage. Let's put our hands together for him. your hands together for him. That was a great performance. Put your hands together. Amen. Amen. Stars. Stars. We are shining brighter and brighter. Amen. I'm going to call on Blessing Oriola for spoken words. Blessing Oriola, please.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are brilliant beyond measures. We ask ourselves, who am I to be gorgeous, brilliant, talented, fabulous? Actually, who are we not to be? Stars. Stars light, stars bright. You are a star created to shine in darkness, a light brought into greatness. Sister, shine. Even when it feels like there is no way out and you are stuck, blocked, feel all alone, do not let fear be your tone or defeat. Shake your feet, brother, shine. Until your passion to make impact is satisfied, keep pushing, keep pressing, keep moving, break grounds and above the ceilings, because you can do anything through Christ who strengthens. Your kind of light wasn't made to hide but shine. It's not an innovation by any man, it's by God. And it's been signed, and you have been assigned, that you are not just any kind, you are unique and not weak. This light is not just in some, it is in all of us. We have all been called to shine. It's time for us to manifest the glory of God that is within us. So why have you placed your light under a table, forgetting the God that you know who is capable and that you are well able, as he has said in the Bible? People, brother, sister, shine. I hear you say, I am nothing. I cannot be anything. I am zero. Don't even dare call me a hero. In your heart, I see that you see fear. But my dear, I tell you that in there is a light. You are God's delight, and you can get to any heights. Are you asking, seeking for the way out? How do I become a star? I have the answer. I have the answer. It's not about knowing the way to become a star, but knowing the man who can make you a star. The one who can take you from the ground and wear on you a crown. From a failure to an achiever. From below, you begin to make you glow. I know a man, and that man is Jesus. Today, I prescribe Jesus to you. If you want to shine, I prescribe Jesus. If you want to be a light, I prescribe Jesus. If you want to make impact, I prescribe Jesus. If you want to stand as a rising star, today I prescribe Jesus. Thank you.
More clapping. We're going to have the next spoken word by Patient Enokela.
Philosopher once said, and I quote, "Determination and courage are the cornerstones of success. Every man is created in the image of God, both rich and poor, young and old, to fulfill destiny. If life was as long brother's necktie, then hope dwells in the strip. If death was as far as mother's mind, then hope is built on our faces. If our future is as precious as gold, then we will stand tall as rising stars. Jesus Christ shines in the sky. Led the three wise men from the east to Bethlehem, where Jesus was, to worship him, according to Matthew 2, verse 2. Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumuyi rose from obscurity to limelight and became a great defender of faith, earnestly contending for it as the book of Jude 1, verse 3 admonishes. Little was he, a great defender of faith, caught the glimpse of Jesus' exploits. A compassionate man who was once lost in his own world of infantile. Little did he know that his obstinance was just the devil's stupidity. He was wallowing in devil's insanity, and he captured him into his vicinity, then placed his calamity upon his priority. He allowed the error of proximity to take over his spirituality, which broke and destroyed the immunity he had with the Almighty. Then he met his great God on the first morning, who took away his non-entity and gave him a new identity. His divinity helped his humanity by restoring his dignity using his own unmeasurable security. Listen, the devil is just a mad mediocre who thinks he has the ability, audacity, alacrity, and ruggedity to touch our peculiarity, prosperity, and connectivity, sparking like electricity that we have with the Almighty. But if we allow generosity, humility, punctuality, and regularity to move along our spirituality, then we put the devil in total brutality, sending him to an outstanding perplexity. Fragile Dugupo once said, "I do not know who needs to hear this, but Jesus was not crucified on a Gucci cross. He didn't have on a crown of Versace tones or Nike shoes on his feet when the nails pressed through. There was nothing bougie about Calvary. That old ragged wooden cross wasn't even befitting to hold a carpenter's son, but there our God hung. Held on by his love for all, by his love for us. It wasn't a red carpet affair for your favorite celeb. Matter of fact, the only paparazzi was an angry mob as crowd of witnesses. Once upon a time, I thought the crucifixion was like the Grammys, an award show for a self-righteous few. But the Bible didn't mention an ovation, only wrongful accusation, hate speeches, boos from fools as the King of Glory came true. But boy, Jesus make a wrong way out of Golgotha. Adjusted that burden of a cross, you would think it was an agbada over his shoulders. I heard it is stated that when Jesus said, "It is finished," that was a fashion statement. Humiliated and stripped, his robe were confiscated like a game of Monopoly, the true dies. Pierced, blood and water flowed from his side. Permit me to say, his drip is eternal to date. By his stripes, we are healed. I guess all I'm saying is, Jesus loves you greatly. Literally, I mean, he braced the cross for you and I. So do not let the devil have the last laugh, because Jesus showed up at the gate of hell and was like, "Knock, knock, guess who is here? Shut down hell's party. Set captivity captive. Who else raises the dead, even in death?" It was just the audacity for me. But the story didn't end there. He showed up on the third day like, "I'm good and you are too. One with the Father, my blood makes you brown new. So what other proof do you need that God loves you? I do not know what your past is, but trust me, Jah is past it. Do not bottle in your shame. God calls you by his name. So when the serpent comes glittering, hissing, whispering deceitful accusation, speaking in parcel tongues, this is clapback season. Declare boldly, my sins are forgiven. It doesn't matter your age, gender, race, or net worth, only that you have been made holy." The treasure wasn't too far from me, but my measures were little. I was dwelling in the incredible pleasure of nature without observing its texture. I was captured by some creatures and deceived with leisure. How will I feature into that venture without making a caricature of his warm gesture? I pictured myself during the promised rapture. Oh, what a mixture of each pleasure. Will I miss it or I will be there? I was matured in the things of God, but had a fracture which moisturized my future of a purpose green pasture. Worthy of note, particularly to all the young ones of my generation, this is the reason why I was born, and my star will shine for Jesus and for Jesus alone. So I equally enjoy you all to arise while standing tall as rising star. See you at the top of the mountain. Thank you and God bless.
Your star for Jesus. Say, my star will shine for Jesus. It will be so in Jesus' name. The final one for tonight is going to be a special number by Prince and Bassi. Let's put our hands together for Prince and Bassi.
Without the ones like you working tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. No matter your industry, Grainger's here for you with professional-grade supplies. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord! If you know you're a rising star, standing tall, shout a louder hallelujah! Good day, everyone. The song we're about to sing now is titled, Jesus, I'll Follow You Across the Miles. As you listen, may you be blessed. Amen.
Into our lives, to constant our devotion to you, Lord. There are friends who question our stand, to make no sense of it, and wonder if we're saved.
Put your hands together for all our presenters. Put your hands together for them. Please keep clapping, clap, clap. The louder your clap, the greater your blessing. The louder your clap, the greater your blessing. The louder you clap, the greater your blessing. The louder you clap, the greater your blessing. Standing tall as a rising star. Amen. It's now time for Anatello. And for the Anatello this evening, it's going to be about blogging. So please, let's remain calm and wait to get into that session. God bless you as you listen.
Every time you step up to the grill, you gotta deliver. And flavor is the last thing you have to worry about. Because no one flavors like we flavor. Grillmates. Flame and flavor.
Hello.